This is the zero notch sample being loaded into the jig. Two supports at the bottom, load applied from the central one at the top. Load's now being applied, very slow movement of the crosshead above. And there's sample failure. The two halves have now been brought back together, and as you can see, they fit together quite well. There's no apparent change in shape prior to failure, so this is typical of a brittle failure with no plastic deformation, no permanent change in shape, other than the crack, of course. This is the 1 mm notch sample. You can just see the 1 mm notch on the bottom surface. The notch is opposite where the load is being applied from the top. And because the notch is on the bottom surface, it is in tension in this particular scenario, three-point bending. It's important that the notch is in tension, not compression. The load is being applied. The viewer will not be able to see that the sample has failed, but it's obvious from the data that's been collected that the load has suddenly dropped. Just wait for failure. So the sample has failed at this point. Here are the two halves. Much less energy than in the previous sample that didn't have a notch. So at this point the fracture surface is being measured, which will come into view in a second. So this is the distance from the bottom of the notch through to the other side of the sample. If you subtract this distance from the overall size, you have the actual notch depth.